Hi everyone. In our last topic, we have discussed about integral calculus. In integral calculus, we see that area problem motivate integral calculus, in which we have discussed about integral, integrand. Then we see some standard formula which helps us to find out integration there. Now in today topic, we are going to be move to be understand the next concept. How can we solve how can we find integrand or integral by using trigonometric identities? Then today we are going to discuss about how can we integrate, find the value of integration of sine square x cos square, because in our last classes we have discussed about formula or some standard form there, integration of x to power n dx, integration of cos x sine x. There is not any single formula which belongs to integration of something of a function square. To get the when you have the problem, we find out this integration of cos square x dx. In such type of problems, we are just going to be substitute by using trigonometric identities. Let's look how can we solve it. We'll start with to find out the integration of sine square x dx. Look, how can we get the integration of sine square x dx? Look up, we have not a formula about getting the square up. Then we have to be using trigonometric identities there. Now what we have, we have formula cos 2x equal to 1 minus 2 sine square x. Now to get the value of sine square x, what we have? To get sine square x, we have, shifting this to the right, to our left, then it's to right, then we have 1 minus 2 sine square x equal to 1 minus cos 2x. Then we get the value of sine square x is what? 1 minus cos 2x by 2. Then also we have a formula cos 2x equal to 2 cos square x minus 1. And we just suppose we have a problem to solve sine square x, then at the place of sine square x we are going to substitute by using identity 1 minus cos 2x by 2. If we get here some problems to solve integration of cos square x, then what do we do? We can change from here. From here, what do we get the value of cos square x? The value of cos square x is given by 1 plus cos 2x by 2. Now look, this when we are going to solve the value of cos square x, we have to substitute 1 plus cos 2x by 2, and to solve anywhere there it's a form of sine square x, then we use there 1 minus cos 2x by 2. Now we are going to be solve this problem. We have to find the integration of sine square x. Look, we see that the value of sine square x is by our identity, it's substitute by 1 minus cos 2x by 2. To get the value of this integral sign, integral value, we move to integration of sine square x dx by using identity. We put here 1 minus cos 2x by 2. Now this divide in this 2 is our constant, our k part. We can take it outside to our integral sign. Now we have 1 minus cos 2x dx. Now it's of the function of type f1x minus f2x, then we can take the integration of f1x minus integration of f2x, then we 1 by 2 into 1, 1 by 2 dx minus 1 by 2 cos 2x dx. Now in last classes we have discussed there the value of our integration of dx is what? It's a x. Now when we have the we know that ddx of sine x is our cos 2x, then integration of cos x is sine x, but here we have cos 2x. Then whenever we have a problem like integration of cos ax cos ax dx, we get the value. In differentiation, when we are going to find out any values, there's ddx of sine x cos x and ddx of sine 2x is we get
2 sine 2x. Here in the integration, in differentiation, coefficient is comes out in the multiplication. But what happened in integration? Our coefficient part with variable, our constant part is comes outside to our division part. We can discuss it when we are going to be using our substitution method there. We have today, since we have used integration using here in trigonometric identities, then we just you have to be learned. If we have something integration of cos ax dx, then what do we have? We have sine ax divided by a. Now we are using this concept there. Now since we have to find out the value of this place, what we have? We have 1 by 2, this value get x, then it's x by 2, and using this integration of cos ax, here we get 2x, then what we get? Minus 1 by 2, we get sine, this is our ax, divided by 2, and our plus c, our constant part, plus c. Now, after simplify, we have x by 2 minus 1 by 2. Sorry, it's a 1 by 4 sine 2x plus c, or x by 2 minus sine 2x by 4 plus c. Now, this is our value of integration of what we get? The value of integration of our sine square x is after solution using trigonometric identity. What we have? We get x by 2 minus sine 2x by 4 plus c. Now we are moved to with our next problem. Now here we have to find out the lookup. The problems like whenever we have the integration of cos square x, then to get just change out by using 1 plus cos 2x by 2, and in a similar way, that's how can we solve this problem. We can write down 1 by 2 dx plus 1 by 2 cos 2x dx, and then we get the value of what? It's x by 2 plus, we just getting here a plus x by 2 plus sine 2x by 4 plus c. Now here we have it's a square to whole square. Now it's a, we have just a sine square x dx. Now we have it's a square of last problem. Here we have integration of sine to power 4x dx. Now it's look difficult to solve, but again, what we do in our last problem, we just changing our sine square x by 1 minus cos 2x. Then here in a similar manner, just using the same concept here, was look here we just going to change its sine square x whole square dx. We write down its sine square x to whole square to getting sine 2 power 4x. Now in last problem, what do? In the place of sine square x, we put 1 minus cos 2x by 2 there. Now what we have? We have 1 minus cos 2x by 2 whole square dx. Now we are going to be open this, taking write down it's 1 by 2 minus cos 2x by 2. It's a form of a minus b whole square, or then we are going to using our a minus b format there. Then what we have? It's a 2 whole square, taking 1 by 4 outside to our integral sign. Now what do we have? We have here a square plus b square minus 2ab, means minus 2 cos 2x, and this is our dx. Now we are going to, this is our f1x plus f2x plus f3x. Then we can write down it's taking 1 by 4 integration of 1 into dx. We have dx plus 1 by 4 cos square 2x, and then this we get minus 1 by 2 cos 2x dx. Now in last we have changes. We have just talking about how can we change our cos square x. We have changed our cos square x is 1 plus cos 2x by 2. Now here what we have? Here we have a cos square 2x. Here is a 2. Then when we are putting here 2x, then here we get 2 to the 4x. Then our cos square 2x is substituted by 1 plus cos 4x by 2. write down 1 by 4 integration of dx plus here we can change y. We have to change it's our cos square x, then 1 plus cos 2x by, but here we have cos square 2x, and it's a 1 plus cos 4x by 2. 1 plus cos 4x by 2, using trigonometric identity we change our cos square 2x. We get the value of cos 2x using the formula what we discuss here. Integration of cos x dx is what? It's a sin x by a. Now write down here, it's minus 1 by 2 cos 2x dx. Now integration of dx is what? We have already discussed, we get x here, then it's a 1 by 4 into x, here we get x by 4. Now again we are going to be here take e dx. Now 1 by 4 into 1 by 2, we get 1 by 8 integration of dx, and then this plus 1 by 8 integration of cos 4x dx minus 1 by 2 integration of cos 2x dx. Now using the our last formula what we have discussed there, integration of cos x cos ax is given by sin ax by a, then it's our x by 4, again we get here x, then x by 8 plus what do we get? It's a sin 4x by 4, 8 4 32, means we get here 32 denominator, and it's our sin 4x. Similarly it's a minus 1 by 2 1 by 2, we get 4, it's a sin 2x by 4, and plus our constant term there. Now look, we get the integration of this. What we get? we get our values there. We are just interchanging the values. Since we have a sin square x dx, then we we are going to use our basic concept. Using the place of sin square x, it's a 1 minus cos 2x by 2. Then after that, we are using our formula there. Expanding 1 minus cos 2x whole square, we get it's a square 1 plus cos square 2x. Then after that, it's a square plus b square, then minus 2ab, then minus 2 cos dx. Then after we are using our 1 by 4, then we use 1 by 4 and solving our cos. Its value cos square 2x by using the concept 1 plus cos 4x by 2 there. And after that, what do we get? 1 by 8. It's changing again the last topic. At the place of cos square 2x, we get 1 plus cos 4x by 2. Then here we get our formula there. Now we get our sin 4x by 32 minus 1 by sin 2x by 4. And we can solve it. We can write down it's taking the LCM there. What do we get? It's a LCM of 4 and 8 is what? It's a 8, 4, 2, 8 and 8, 1, 8. Then it's a 3x by 8 plus sin 4x by 32 minus sin 2x by 4 plus c. This is our required answer of sin to power 4x. We just using our identity two times. So first of all, we changing our sin square x by 1 minus cos 2x by 2. Then after that, expanding a minus b whole square, we change our cos square 2x by 1 plus cos 4x by 2. Then after that, we just using our integral fundamental formula forms there. Then after simplify, we get our result there. Now we are now move to with our next problem. It's a function of two product of two function there. It's now we have seen there is two functions. One function is sin 3x and second function is cos 4x. Now we have to solve, we have to find out the integration of sin 3x into cos 4x. Again we can find out the integration by using our trigonometric basic identity there. What it's just look, it's a form of, if you take this a, now sin sin into cos b, have you remembered about some formula about we get sin into cos b? Just you remember the formula, it's about 2 sin a into cos b. When we take 2 here, multiplying by 2. And our 2 sin A into cos B, remember that? How can we get our 2 sin A into cos B? We get our 2 sin A into cos B by using the concept there. What is our identity there? It's a sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. When we use our sin A plus B plus sin A minus B, we get the result 2 sin A into cos B. What means of when we are able to find the value of something sin A into cos B, just we need 2 there. Then our sin A into cos B will change by, we just change it by 1 by 2 sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. Similarly, we can use our other concept there. We can find out getting the value of sin A into cos B. We can also, in similar manner, we can find out the identity by cos A into cos B, cos A into sin B. We can change our other identity by using this same, the same way. Now we have sin A into cos B is what? It's a 1 by 2 sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. Then we are going to be using our trigonometric identity there. Now we are take our problem. Sin 3x into cos 4x using our trigonometric identity. It's a sin A into cos B is changed by 1 by 2 sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. Then we write down 1 by 2 sin A plus B 3x plus 4x. What do we get? It's our sin 7x plus sin A minus B 3x minus 4x. We get sin minus x dx. Now what do? We are just going to taking the individual function there. Now we have 1 by 2 sin 7x dx, and this, now we have to change this. It's a sin minus theta. Sin minus theta is what? It's our minus sin theta. Then we get here minus also. A minus 1 by 2 integration of sin x dx. Now look, it's the integration of sin ax dx. Then how we get the integration of sin is what? It's a the dx of cos x is what? It's a minus sin x. The integration of sin x, it's a minus cos x, but we have a coefficient there. Then we get 7 in the denominator. Now it's a minus, it's 7, it's a what? Minus 1 into 2, 1 sorry, 7 into 2 is what? It's a 14. And then it's our cos 7x minus 1 by 14 cos 7x. Now again we take here minus there, then minus minus plus 1 by 2 cos x, and then our plus c. Now we are going to just write down here, it's a cos x by 2 minus cos 7x by 14 plus c. Please don't do any single mistake there. This is our angle. I hope so you hear that. Don't be using that. Cancel out this 7 to 14 there. Please, this is our cos 7x and divided by 14. Now, this is our integration of, we get here integration of sin 3x into cos 4x. The value of sin 3x into cos 4x is what? It's given by cos x by 2 minus cos 7x by 14 plus c. What we use there? We use our trigonometric identity, our sin A into cos B, converted to 1 by 2 sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. Just using this our trigonometric identity, after that we are using our fundamental trigonometric formulas. The integration of our sin A, we just use our integration of sin AX DX is what? It's a minus cos AX by A plus C. By using the basic formula there, we get our integral values there. Now we are move to our next problem. Now in last problem we have two product there. Now there is three trigonometric product, sin x, sin 2x, sin 3x. Now here we have to find out the values of sin x into sin 2x into sin 3x. We have to get the integration of this. Now there is a function of three, we have a it's a function of product of three functions. Then what do we do? Just we are going to use the concept. We take first this sin x into sin 2x. We use this and lefting of our sin 3x. First of all, we are going to change this is our sin x into sin 2x by using the concept formula. What is what we have when we have sin a into sin b? Now look, in last problem we have convert our sin a into cos b in the terms of 1 by 2 sin a plus b plus sin a minus b. Now we have to convert sin a into sin b. How can we get? What is the formula? Our sin a into sin b, what? It's changed by, what is the formula there? Our formula is what? It's a 1 by 2 cos a minus b minus cos a plus b. When we are going to take difference between cos a minus b minus cos a plus b, remember that cos a minus b, what? It's a cos a into cos b plus sin a into sin b. Cos a into cos b plus sin a into sin b. It's a cos a into cos b minus sin a into sin b. Then we are going to take difference. Then our cos a into cos b cancel out. Then we have 2 times sin a into sin b. And then divided by 2, we get our sin a into sin b. Now we can change our sin a into sin b. 1 by 2 cos a minus b minus cos a plus b. Then look. From here, what we do? We write down at the place of sin x into sin 2x 1 by 2 cos a minus b. It means x minus 2x. Remember that our x minus 2x, it's minus x, but our cos minus theta is cos theta. Then there is no change in sign. Then we have cos x. Just look that x minus 2x, we get cos of minus x, but our cos minus theta is given by cos theta. That that's why we just cos x here. Then cos x minus cos a plus b x plus 2x, it's a cos 3x. Now we have 1 by 2 into cos x minus cos 3x, and this is our, write down here, our into sin 3x dx. Now what we do? We are going to take multiplication up in both using both terms. We have, what we get? We get now it's 1 by 2 cos x into sin 3x, and similar in the similar way 1 by 2 cos 3x into sin 3x dx. Now it's a cos into sin b, because it's like a form of sin a into cos b form. We using sin a plus b plus sin a minus b format there. Then now we are using our last identity there. It's a cos x into sin 3x into cos x. Then what do we get? We get change in sin a plus b plus sin a minus b. Then it's a sin, taking sin 3x first. Then now it's a again here we 1 by 2. Then we have already also we get 1 by 2, because when we use our sin a into cos b, we have 1 by 2 sin a plus b plus sin a minus b. We take sin a, sin 3x at sin a. Then 1 by 2, 1 by 2 get here 1 by 4. It's a sin a plus b, means we get our sin 3x plus x sin 4x there, and plus sin a minus b means sin 3x minus x sin 2x there. And write down dx here. Now again it's a sin a into cos b, and the same formula we are using. What do we get? It's a just a look, it's our values are same there. Then we are not, it's a 3x into 3x. Then we are just going to be taking a 2 multiply up to and divide up to. It's a 2 cos a into sin a. It's our sin 2a. Means we just using our identity, it's now convert to our sin 6x dx. We are not going to use our you can also apply the same formula, but you get already sin 6x already there. Using any identity there. Now what we now we are going to find out, it's a 1 by 4 integration of sin 4x dx
plus 1 by 4 integration of sine 2x dx minus 1 by 4 integration of sine 6x dx. Again, the integration of sine, the dx of cos x is minus sine x, then we getting minus already the, in here, here and here, and our coefficient in the numerator part. Then we get up, it's of minus cos 4x by 4, 4, 4, 16, then it's our minus cos 4x by 16. Here we get plus minus minus, again 1, 4, it's sorry, it's a 2, 1 by 4 into 2, it's a 1 by 8, then it's our cos 2x, and here we get 6, 4, minus 24 cos 6x and plus c. What do you get? Minus cos 4x by 16, minus cos 2x by 8, and minus minus cos 6x by 24 plus c. This is our integration of sin x into sin 2x into sin 3x. Now we are moved to with our next problem. It is a trigonometric problem. It's not again, it's a based on identity. But here we are not going to, but using our formula, trigonometric formula is there. Look, it's a sin 8 to power x minus cos 8 to power x. Then we can write down its can write down it's a sine 4 to power x whole square minus cos 2 power 4 whole square, and in denominator we can change our 1 by cos square x plus sine square x. Now in numerator what we do, we are going to just using our basic identity, algebraic identity, a square minus b square, then what do we get? We get here a minus b and a plus b, a minus b, a plus b, and here write down the same way cos square x plus sine square x minus 2 sine square x into cos square x. Now what we do, we are going to just change this sine to power 4x plus cos to power 4x, just written as our sine to power x minus cos to power 4x in the same manners. Now we can write down this sine, our sine to power 4x plus cos to power 4x as, how can write down? It's can be written as, we can when we have any forms of a to power 4 plus b to power 4, how we can transform it? It's a square plus b square whole square. We get a to power 4 plus b to power 4 plus 2a square b square, then we can use minus 2a square and b square. Using this identity, we are going to be convert this, then we can write down its sine square x plus cos square x whole square, and minus, what we do, minus 2 sine square x into cos square x. Sine square x into cos square x upon look, we don't need to be convert one there. We are going to again change its one, because we, now what we get, what we do, we get sine to power 4x minus cos to power 4x. Here what we get, we get it's a 1 minus 2 sine square x into cos square x. Again, we not going to change here. 1, we can write on 1 minus 2 sine square x into cos square x. These are same, these are same function, cancel out. Now what we have, we have now its integration of sine to power 4x minus cos to power 4x dx. Look, when we take minus common there, then what we have now, look, first of all, we are going to simplify it. It can be written as now sine square x plus cos square x, and then it's a sine square x
minus cos square x dx. Now what we do? It's a 1. Then what we have? Finally, we have sin square x minus cos square x dx. Now what we do? We are going to taking minus common there. Then what we have? We have cos square x minus sin square x dx. This can be changed by cos 2x dx. And now we know the integration of cos 2x. It's what? It's a minus 1 by 2 sin 2x plus c. This is our integration of. Now we, in next class, we are going to discuss with our next topic there.